if this was a few years ago, I probably wouldn't have taken this role, because I used to, in my head, I'd say, my acting is here, my music is here. Hey. It's been 20 years since we've been on stage together, and now we're gonna perform at the biggest Black award show in the world in 4 days. Tell me how this isn't gonna be a disaster.
What drew you to this role, the story about four women who are rappers in the 90s, reuniting 20 years later, and resurrecting their careers?
I have to say, when I first heard about the idea, I kind of was like, this could be not great. And then I spoke to Zahir McGee and Sabrina Nguyen, who are the EPs, and Zahir is the creator of the show. And then I read the script and I fell in love with the script, because it wasn't just about these girls, these women who were trying to do music and claw back at their careers. It was about these four women of substance that have real lives, that come together again and realize that they also need each other in sisterhood and friendship. And when I saw that, and I saw that it was like meaty and like, wow, we're really gonna dive deep into some real subjects, I was definitely like, sign me up, 100%.
But tonight is tonight, and I'm going on stage without Naomi. I'm gonna show the world that P-Sex still has it. And I only wanna know one thing. Are y'all riding with me or what?
If this was a few years ago, I probably wouldn't have taken this role, because I used to, in my head, I'd say, my acting is here, my music is here. But to be able to do it together is actually, it's way more fun than I thought it would be. But also, it's two things I love. So yeah, I mean, it's been great. It's been really, really great. And to be able to do it where it's, yes, I'm rapping. Yes, it is me, of course. But to be Professor Sex, to be this other rapper is so dope to me.
I love that that's the name of your character.
Yes, I love it. I love her name.
And we know you obviously from your sitcom. You were on Eve. We know you from The Toxic, but you now you're in a dramatic role. How'd you have to prepare for that?
It was learning as I went along, to be honest. But also, I mean, shout out to my acting coach as well, Tracy Moore. She's amazing. So when I needed some help, I would definitely call her. We shot so fast, though, that a lot of the time it was making sure I was just into the material on set. And it also depended on we've had great directors, and that's been great as well. Like them working with me when it comes to emotion, which is something I'm not very comfortable with. oh my God. And I'm still learning. And it was learning as I went along and being comfortable with opening myself up that much. And hopefully I did a good job. I don't know. I hope I did. But at the same time, it was a nice challenge. It was a very nice challenge. And it makes me want to go deeper, actually.
Well, you play Brianna, who is the mother of five. And we all know that you're expecting your first child with your husband. So how are you preparing for this next phase of motherhood? We know you're a devoted stepmom, but this is going to be a little different.
This is definitely going to be different, because now it's obviously I'm fully involved from the beginning. I've been very lucky, because I do think my bonus kids have helped me just with patience and understanding. And because before my husband, I hadn't been around kids for years. These kids have been in my life for 11 years. So they've taught me a lot. But I am now ready for that big role. I've been saying this, like, I'm happy that I'm going to be an older mom, because my patience and my presence, being there. I just can't wait to be a smother mother. It's going to be the best thing ever.